Anytime. We're looking out for you.
I still don't trust him. He swore he heard him yell and give the go-ahead that they're in the clear. Outlet. Let's do some investigating of our own here.
You can definitely tell they built this thing themselves. They're storing gasoline all over the property.
Mm-hmm. They must run out of it pretty quickly.
That thing keeps a fence electrified.
Just that one little thing? I mean, I swear, for this kind of charge, you need a couple of these, at least. A few.
I guess Mark and I were lucky we weren't touching this thing when it came on.
I think we were supposed to be touching it. I do not trust these people.
If a couple of tools out in the open is as unsafe as it gets, we'll be fine here. Would have been nice to have one of these back at the motor inn. Hmm. I'll bet they go through a lot of wood keeping those fences repaired.
Hey, Clementine.
Hey, Clem. Do you like the swing?
Yeah, it's fun.
Be sure to tell Andy thank you, okay?
I will. Will you push me on it?
Sure.
Sure. Happy to push you on the swing. Mind if Clementine takes a turn?
All right, Duck. Let Clementine have a try for a bit.
Okay.
Ninja stance. Aw. Where should I swing? How you doing?
How you holding up, Clementine?
I'm okay, I guess. Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm just a little worried about Mark.
Is Mark going to be okay?
You're lucky out there. Could have been a lot worse.
Are you going to find the people who hurt Mark?
Well, we have to make sure they don't hurt anyone else.
Be careful. I want you to stay lucky, too.
Ever since I met you, I've had good luck, so don't worry.
Okay.
What do you think of the dairy?
What do you think of the dairy?
It's pretty. It reminds me of how things used to look before.
Yeah, it does.
Do you think things will ever get back to how they were?
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure, Clem. I hope so.
I hope so, too.
I'm not sure if we're safe here, so I'm just gonna say, hey, exit.
All right, Clint. That's enough for now.
Okay. Thanks for pushing me.
Of course. It's all yours.
Yeah!
Okay, Duck. Don't pop a gasket.
He had a dirty look on his face. Talk to Kenny. Don't get by that swing now.
Hey.
Hey, Lee. Found anything interesting?
I was talking to Andy a bit earlier. Doesn't sound like they have too many guns around. They rely mostly on the fence to keep them safe.
So long as you're on this side, things are all right. Provided the fence holds out.
Well, that's the problem. When there's no more gas, there's no more fence.
That's true. Well, it's good to know what we're working with here. Keep looking around, and let me know if you find anything else.
How you holding up?
How you holding up?
I hope they feed us, Lee. Soon. On the way over here, I was getting dizzy. Hands shaking, cold sweats. Thought I was gonna pass out.
They've got food here.
Yeah, but I'm not just talking about one meal, you know?
Lily doesn't want to be here, in case you haven't noticed.
I guess, Lily isn't too thrilled about being here?
I could give two shits about what Lily wants. Duck and Katja need food, and I'm not about to sit around that motor inn and watch them go hungry. You're with me on this, right?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, of course. Lily's judgment is clouded, but you got a pretty clear head about these things.
Your family made it here okay?
Did Duck and Katja get here okay?
No, it wasn't easy. Duck didn't look so good on the walk over to this place.
Well, if everything works out, maybe he and Katja can have an easier life here.
I hope you're right. Duck and Clementine deserve a better life than starving to death at some crappy motel.
I'm gonna go have a look around.
Don't wait too long to help scope out that bandit camp. It'd be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about the St. Johns and their relationship with those bandits or whatever.
Right. I'll see what I can find out.
I can just hold that there and it goes click, click. Kenny and Katja are a pretty interesting couple. She's Polish, I think, or Russian. And he's like this good old southern boy. Let's look at the swing, if we can. Look at it.
They look happy.
That's not the swing, it's a people. Not electrified. Pointy? I came all this way just for pointy? It's a pretty big area. Hay pile. Hey, pile!
Looks like a feeding station for the cow.
Cornfield. Show them the corn!
Having a crop like that on hand must be great. We're gonna need to learn how to maintain it if we end up staying here.
Corn's better than nothing, but it really just goes right through you. We can go up on this. Oh boy. Like we really want to talk to that jack. I'll be nice. Well, we don't have an option to talk to him. I'm sure he's gonna butt in when we talk to Lily, though. Slow motion walk. I can't go up on there, huh?
Lee, oh my god, I'm so glad you two didn't get killed out there. Do you think Mark will be okay?
You really care?
Wish I knew, but I think he's in good hands now.
Yeah? It's not too bad?
He'll be fine. I've seen guys go through worse.
How could you all bring us to this place?
Well, how do you feel about leaving the motor in?
How do you feel about leaving the motor in?
It's a welcome change of scenery.
He's actually saying something positive?
I don't know. If we'd just stayed where we were, then Mark wouldn't have ended up with an arrow in his shoulder.
I take it you and Kenny haven't made up.
I take it you and Kenny didn't exactly make up on the way here.
I tried seeing things from his point of view, having a wife and kid and everything. But gambling with your family's life is pretty stupid if you ask me. Hey, thanks for backing me up this morning at the motel. I know I came down on you guys pretty hard, but you do agree with the way I'm running things, right?
You're a good leader.
You're a good leader, Lily. Kenny's too emotional, but his intentions are in the right place. Still, it'd be best for all of us if you two could try to work together once in a while.
She needs a little more compassion. I was actually surprised that she was feeling so glad that we were okay. Figure she'd just be like, oh yeah, two less mouths to feed. Awesome.
Hey.
About your dad. He's a real jerkwad.
Hey, can I talk to you in private for a second?
Okay. Oh yeah, let's whisper. Hey, about your dad. He's a real jerkwad.
It's been 3 months. Your dad still treats me like I'm some kind of asshole.
Yeah, well, don't expect that to change. That's just how he is.
Takes one to know one. So he's... yeah. Does he treat you like that,
Does
too?
Does he treat you like that, too?
Look, my dad can be an ass sometimes. I know that. But
sometimes.
He's not a bad guy. He just... he's got a lot of pain. He's been through so much. And lost... pretty much everything. And it's hardened him, you know? Yeah, he's bitter and hateful, but that's all just to protect himself. And me. All he's got left in the world is me. And that goes both ways. So yeah, he's probably gonna keep treating you like crap, but that's just because he still has one thing left to care about. So don't judge him. And don't judge me for sticking by him. He's my dad. And I love him.
He's still a jerkwad. So you think this is a good idea?
Think our little arrangement with them was a good idea?
A little late to be asking that now, don't you think?
Dad's right.
No one asked you.
Let's just wait for dinner. And then if Mark is feeling up to it, we leave. I don't want to push our luck here.
Now, let's not be hasty.
Make up your mind.
Check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, and we don't need you poking your nose where it don't belong and getting us thrown out in our asses.
All right, Scooby-Doo, it's enough. You're having a war in your head also, and we don't care enough about you to want to pay attention. What? Oh, I got scared. I'm like, what was that? Anything else to look at? Can we look at the cow? The diseased cow inside?
If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Oh, we're looking at it, not opening it. It said use barn door.
If there's not enough room in the house for all of us, I guess a few of us could camp out here in shifts.
Okay, guys, next time I'm at home, when I want to use a door, I'm just going to stand there and talk to it instead. Because this game's got the right idea. I know, I'm such a smartass. Is that the same hay we were looking at before?
Lots of hay. Enough of these might work as adequate cover from arrows, if that becomes a problem.
That's a good idea. That's a really good idea. Getting arrows. So the arrow nailed one of the walkers. Is there anyone else here who has arrows? Do any of these people have arrows, or just these bandits? There's quite a lot to explore here. I'm gonna go through that in a sec. This just leads back to the swing, right? Okay. Howdy, partners.
Fellas. How you feeling?
Or fellas.
Look, I'm really sorry you almost got killed out there. We should have told you how dangerous it was.
No shit.
You saw what they did to your buddy. Nobody's safe here until we start to fight back.
But how?
The two of us should go out and do some recon. Then we'll all mount up for some revenge.
Hell yeah.
Mount up?
Who the fuck are these people in the woods?
They got horses?
We don't know. I think some of them used to work at the big box up the way.
Big Save box? Us.
Yeah. Anyway, they're nutty as all hell and get mad when they're hungry.
So are you ready to head out there and find their camp?
Hangry. Not now. Let's look around. I want to look around some more.
We'll go in a few minutes. Just need to check on a few things before we head out.
Sure, that's understandable. Talk things over with your group. Just come find us when you're ready.
I'll do that.
Hey, I wasn't leaving yet. I can't talk to them about anything else. Should we talk to Kenny about this? And or Lily? Ooh! It actually did hit him, technically.
Kenny, I'm gonna go have a look around.
I'll be here if you need me. Let me know if you find anything.
Alright, well, that wasn't much. Just wondering if we could talk to Lily. No, they're on that side of the gate, right? Okay. How about run and use gate? Yeah, they're on that side. Let me just check with them. Or her. Who cares about him? Look at the gazebo! Attack the gazebo! I hit it with a fireball. What happened? It's on fire.
I'm gonna go check things out.
Just don't get too nosy. These kinds of people are usually pretty protective of their privacy.
Yeah, well, I wanted to go in the barn, but the game wouldn't let me, so... What? When do I get to look at the... Where's the gazebo, man? I want the thing for the gazebo. I got all the way back here just to walk all the way back and look at it. Pretty nice, and that's all he says.
Quaint. Doesn't offer much in the way of protection, though.
Oh, sure doesn't. Okay, let's see if these good old boys, the Dairy Brothers, have anything to say. Else to say, or we'll just get ready to go mount up and go with some bandits. I don't know if they mean literally. Do they have horses? Because I don't see any. In the barn, maybe? Why would they keep the horses in the barn during the day, though? Might have just been jargon, you know, mount up.
Hey, Lee.
Change your mind about going out to track down them bandits?
Them bandits, yeah, let's go.
Yeah, it'll be a good opportunity to find out a bit more about what we're up against. Let's do it.
I'll stay here and hold down the fort.
Remember, we're just doing reconnaissance for now. No use getting ourselves killed.
Is there ever any use getting yourself killed?
Are you going now?
Yeah.
Aww. I'll be back soon, Clementine.
So cute.
Please be lucky.
I will.
Aww. Let's see a picture of the little girl who did her voice. Watch, it's like an adult with the voice, like, the pitch changed. You know, the props really bother me. It looks like purely cut out of, like, cardboard or something.
I know it's around here. It's gotta be close.
The axe looked bad, too. I know they're going for that look, but it's just not my thing. Soup Express. Yeah, that's not our quarry.
Here.
What you got there? Ooh.
Oh, shit. You found it?
Found something. That control was wonky. Sneak up to the camp. Nothing to look at, just sneaking. Is there an inside, like, fortress or something? Or is it just all out here? How close are we supposed to sneak? Well, I guess that close.
You see anybody?
No. Can't tell.
Can't tell.
Watch my back, Lee.
They're in the tent. They're in the tent. Well, those are gonna have a walker tied up in the tent just for when someone comes up to it. Mind you, I have no idea what's gonna happen. I might be lucky with my foretelling.
Clear.
Not this time.
This camp's too small. It can't be their main base.
That's what I was thinking.
Oh, there's save lots boxes.
Take a look around anyway. There's probably some shit around here they stole from us.
Well, the save lots boxes could be them. One of them worked there. Or stolen. So these bottles.
Empty. But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently.
Yeah, that's... people do that. They eat. Save lots.
Just water.
It's in the box. It's in the box! Her pretty head.
Empty.
Nope, no head in there. Why are you moving it with your gun? What are you doing, exactly? Why'd he move the box? He just pushed it over there. Is there some reason for that?
Nothing.
Is he trying to see if something was underneath the box? I mean, it would have to be paper or something.
Tent looks pretty new. Anybody inside?
Two sleeping bags. One of them's kid-sized.
Hmm. This guy should be back any time. Save lots.
Looks like they were moving a lot of stuff.
You know what they got? Food from people? That they stole from people? What's in that box? Zombie head?
What's in the boxes?
They're all from Save Lots.
The first few days they told folks to gather to the Save Lots by the interstate. Anything worth taking?
This is too much for one person.
This is too much stuff for just one person.
Trust me, these selfish bastards don't stop taking. Probably just to remind us that it's theirs.
And we also don't know how many of them there are. Did we look at this box already? What is he? St. John's Dairy.
Boxes from the dairy here.
Probably the food we've been giving them. Fuckers cross the line.
I wonder if these guys are one and the same. What's that? A camera? I thought it was like a mini cassette recorder or something.
What'd you find?
What'd you find?
Video camera.
None of your business.
Let me see that.
No. It's my video camera. I want to see what's on it.
Battery's dead, though.
Oh, good. What else they got over here? Let's see if we can find anything useful and then get a move on.
Why good?
I see you handled that gun I lent you pretty well. You a hunter?
No, but Lily keeps us all on a regular training schedule.
Don't try to distract me.
Lily, huh? Sounds like she's running this democracy of yours.
He's trying to distract us. Battery's dead. Oh, good. Who the hell says that? He does not want us to see what might be on that camera.
Nothing but fuse. Shit.
The teleporting dairy dude. Oh, a lawn chair? That's important.
Looks like they expected to be here a while.
This guy keeps teleporting away from the tent. Damn his mysticism. We already looked at the bottles. Stuff down here. Trash. What kind of trash?
Yuck.
More soup cans.
I don't need that.
What else is there to look at? I looked at the bottles.
But it looks like someone's been eating out of these. Recently.
Recently, yes. There's something else we have to look at, obviously. Look at the tent now that he's not standing by it, maybe? Where'd he go? Is he gone? Bloody bunny. Shopping bag. Photo. Watch her hats. There's someone sleeping. Oh no. That's his hand. I'm like, there's someone laying down here. I thought this was a blanket or something. Or a sleeping bag, and that was someone's hand sticking out. There's a walker in there. Her hat.
The hell?
Don't fucking move! Shit!
Put your guns down.
I ain't going back.
It's a freaking wildling.
Jolene ain't going back.
You belong north of the wall.
We had a deal. No shooting as long as we gave you food. What the fuck happened?
What?
You had a deal with them. I ain't them. Oh, I know you. I know what you are. And I know what you do.
You don't know me.
What do we do?
Steal my shit.
What do they do?
Steal everything from
me. Who are you?
Who the fuck are you?
Laughing woman,
look,
obviously.
It's not safe up here in the woods. You gotta come back to the dairy.
Oh, it's a hell of a lot safer up here than down there, you best believe. Now, maybe you didn't hear me last time.
Kind of believe her.
When I asked you, sweet, put your damn guns down! You think I won't kill you? I'm gonna take this here crossbow and put a nice sharp arrow right through your eyeball and into your goddamn brain. You're not men. You're monsters. All men are monsters.
Huh.
Take what they want and then destroy it all. Take a can of beans. Take a little girl. It's all the fucking same to you.
Screw this.
Y'all wave them guns like you're looking to die.
I just shot Jolene. Shit. Who the hell's Jolene?
What the hell'd you do that for?
She was gonna
deal with them.
She was about to shoot.
She was about to shoot us both.
You could have just taken her down. You didn't have to kill her.
Was there another option?
I mean, I know she was crazy, but damn.
Oh well.
It's a clean shot, though. Right through the forehead. That's good shooting right there. Still, what a waste.
Good shooting, Tex.
So,
yeah, well.
That's it. We going back?
Heat of the moment.
If they ain't here, I don't know where they are. And it ain't a good idea to go tromping through the woods looking for them.
Someone might have heard that shot.
We head back. Once they see this, they'll get the message.
I didn't get to look at the bloody bunny, though.
Come on.
That was a funny look he had. He feels bad about it. I don't know if I had another place to shoot her, like more than one option. I know I had different dialogue options, but maybe I could have shot her in an ace.
That was a hell of a ride, huh?
What?
You were a madman back there. Took that crazy bitch down.
You're back! What happened?
Lee took care of it.
All of a sudden his demeanor has changed. He kind of didn't like the way we did that. And now
this
he likes
isn't
it.
What Terry would have wanted.
Terry?
Who's Terry?
My husband. Miss him every day.
Then screw it up for everybody then, why don't you?
Oh, calm down, princess. I'll do it myself.
What are we gonna do? Fighting again.
What's going on with them?
What's he doing himself?
Don't know. Squabbling, looks like. A lot of tension with y'all, huh?
Yeah, well. You could say that.
Yeah, you could say that. We don't exactly see eye to eye on how we should be doing things.
Well, it's probably just the hunger talking.
Storm's coming.
And Lee, don't worry your head about them bandits. I'm sorry you've seen more violence than I'd have thought in your short time, but you all are safe here. Don't worry.
I think I'll go have a look around.
Don't wander too far. Dinner will be ready before you know it. And thank your friend Koch again for me. She and the kids are in the barn with the cow. That woman is a lifesaver.
I don't trust her. She's way too nice. We need to check on the barn and the kids and the... Okay. Seems okay. Seems alright so far. Why are they closing the door? I really don't trust them.
Pardon me, Brenda.
What's on your mind, Lee?
Get in the kitchen! We ran into some trouble out there.
We ran into some trouble out there.
I was just glad you two weren't hurt. Those bandits just don't know when to quit. But my boys, they can hold their own.
You boys nuts. Why do you deal with bandits?
Why did you make a deal with those people?
We got a threat of humanity left, Lee. We can do more good without them in our hair by placating them. So that's what we do.
How's Mark doing in there?
How's Mark doing in there?
Best patient I ever had. Oh, my boys get so much as a scratch and start hollering. He could definitely teach them a thing or two about being tough.
I'd still like to check on him.
You're gonna have to trust me on this, Lee. I've helped stitch my share of wounds. I know what I'm talking about.
What? We're not allowed to check on him? We are not allowed to check on him. I do not trust these people. There is a lot going on behind the scenes. A lot. So what are you out of here instead of the cooking in the kitchen? Go fetch me a sandwich.
Not to be rude, ma'am. How come you're out here instead of, you know?
Oh, you want to know why I'm not slaving away in the kitchen? Is that it?
No, I didn't mean for it to sound like that.
Oh, it's okay, darling. Got it slow cooking in the oven. Should be ready before too long.
Think I'll go have a look around.
Kinda peaceful out here, ain't it? Enjoy it while you can. You'll probably start hearing those monsters frying against the fence before too long.
The cooking mark. Their cooking mark. He's the red shirt. He's the new guy. He's dead. He's a dead boy. Still swinging on swing? Danny. Oh, yeah, this guy. Oh, he's Danny? What was the governor's real name? Don't think. No, it's Philip.
All fixed. That should make everyone happy.
But he went by many different names. And first, he went by no name. I don't know. He's probably not the governor, guys. I'm just paranoid about the governor because, you know, he's the governor. You know about the governor.
Hello.
That's not even the guy I'm thinking about. You really like that gun.
You really like that gun.
He's caressing
it. What's not to like?
It's just a gun.
It's just a gun.
That's where you're wrong. This is Charlotte. She's as faithful as a starving hound when you got a bone in your pocket.
Charlotte? This place is pretty isolated.
You guys are pretty out in the sticks here.
Hard to find.
You get many visitors?
Not anymore. Bandits, of course. Used to get these school kids on tours back before the dead time.
You run this place with just one cow?
How do you run this place with just one cow?
Used to have more. They get hungry too. Or sick. Got your doctor friend here now, though.
You guys must trade for a lot of fuel to keep the generators running, right?
People get hungry, and a few loaves of bread fetch a high price. Y'all are luckier on this side of the deal now.
I'm gonna go wait for supper then.
It'll be a good one.